Hello, today I'm here with a new video, and if you don't know who I am, my name is Lisa. I'm a calligraphy YouTuber that does some makeup content, and today I am doing a collab and a tag. And the collab is with my friend Madeleine, that has a fairly new start of the makeup channel, and we are doing the makeup tag that I'm pretty sure Angelica and Nyqvist did. And she does it yearly with Samantha Marsh, and it is new makeup releases tag. And I do really like to watch these videos, and Madeleine asked if we were going to do a collab, and I was, yeah, I love to do a collab with you. So we decided on doing this one, and it's going to be so fun to see if Madeleine and I have some of the same answers. And yeah, I will leave all the questions, Angelica's and Samantha's videos down in the description, and also Madeleine, of course. So yeah, Madeleine is a friend of mine. She has recently started her makeup channel, and I'm so happy that she finally did. I have been telling her to start a makeup channel for so long, and I'm just so pleased and happy that she did. She is so sweet, and she has an amazing makeup collection, and you have to check her out. She is from Sweden as I am, but she's doing videos in English. So yeah, when you watch this, please go in and check Madeleine, and I've been dying to see her thoughts on this. But okay, this is 8 questions, and I'm going to try to answer them as good as I can. I have some palettes in front of me, and I think I am prepared. I hope. So the first question is, what mainstream release live up to the hype? And I had a little bit of a hard time with this, because mainstream makeup is maybe not my favorite thing, and I used this palette. Okay, we're getting into this. I took the Wilderness palette from Beauty Bay. I think it started with like the Book of Magic they did that people loved, but it was only a limited edition palette, and people like didn't know, and it was so hyped when it sold out. Then the Wilderness came, and people were crazy. And I did buy it, as you see. And for me, I have used this once, and for me it didn't live up to the hype. So I was like, am I going to take this palette for this question? But it was such a hype about this, and Beauty Bay still keeps going on with hyped palettes, like the Age of Opulence. Is that the last, like these they did? That was pretty hyped, and I think it went pretty good with it. So I guess this lives up to the hype, but not for me. I think I just need to use it more. But like, I was not super pleased with it. I thought it was okay, but it is not expensive at all, and it's a pretty big palette, and it's not a bad palette, it's just not my favorite. But people seem to love this, and it was like the same thing with this as the Book of Magic. It went out of stock, and people were like, is it over? And it come back, and people were crazy again. So yeah, I guess this lived up to the hype, maybe not just for me. So the next question is, what in the release lived up to the hype most this year? And I'm actually going to say, okay, this was hard, because some of these palettes I could have taken on more than one question, but I decided to take the Kaleidos Flower Punk palette. This came out in April or May, I think. It looks like this, and when I tried to buy this, Kaleidos website was out of control. It went in and out of stock, and I was so pissed. I finally did get it, and at first, I wasn't like super pleased with it, but then I did a 2 looks on palette, and this is growing on me for every time I use this, and I just really, really like it. The only thing, I am one of these people that doesn't like the package. I know that a lot of people do, but I don't. But this is such a good palette. I really love the mix with like grungy colors down here together with this more like the pinkish and the blue turquoise. No, not turquoise. Jesus. These bluish colors up here. And this is really, really good. It is Kaleido's normal formula. And the shimmers are so good. And these grungy mattes are such cool colors. And I do really like this. And I think it really deserves the hype that it got when it came out. And Kaleido's does one of my absolute favorite eyeshadows. I think you know that if you have watched my videos. So yeah, I think this lived up to the hype. And it's just a wonderful palette. Then the third question. Yeah, I need to read. The third question, which release did not live up to the hype? And I actually took, because this is my feelings, and I took the Powerpuff Girls and ColourPop. I do think that people were really excited about this, and that the more than me really did like the Powerpuff Girls when they were younger, and I did buy this, as you see. I've used this once, but I think it's pretty boring. For me, it's pretty boring. They could have done so much more fun with this. It is free Powerpuff Girls. It's free lines in this palette, and they should just have done lines and rows. One row for each of the Powerpuff. I don't know why they didn't, and I just don't think this is such a fun palette. And I used this once. I have never been like super excited to use this more. So I think this did not live up to the hype. ColourPop, they do so much releases. I think they're releasing at least once a week. And some of them are really good. And some of them are really bad. And I do not think this lived up to the hype. I think I actually going to decluttering this palette, even though I only used it once, because even though I loved Powerpuff Girls, I loved Bubbles when I was younger, I just don't feel like it is a good palette, and I think they were missing out on so much with this. So yeah, I'm a little bit sad, but it is what it is. And another thing that I don't think that made me a little bit disappointed is actually one thing from Kaleidos. When they were saying that it was going to release an Apple collection in, could have been October or September, I was expecting a palette, and it was only lip products. And I also watched Amy Loves Makeup's video when she did this tag, and she also talked about the Apple collection from Kaleidos, and I just really wished it was more than lipsticks. These new lipsticks from Kaleidos isn't my favorite formula from them. I love their old formula more. And the Apple collection, I think they could have done such an amazing red dark palette. But they only did release new colors in the lip glaze. So I was a little bit disappointed with that. I still though bought the whole collection, but I wished it was more than just 8 new lipsticks. Question number 4 is, what is the biggest curveball of this year? And I going to talk about ColourPop again. They have done a lot of collabs with like Disney and everything, and then there was going to be a Tinkerbell collection. And Tinkerbell, I think she's a bitch. I'm just saying what I feel about Tinkerbell. She is a bitch. If you have watched the movie, if you've watched Peter Pan, you know that she is a little bitch. And they were going to release a Tinkerbell palette, and I'm like, it's going to be the most boring palette ever. But the palette is, it's such a cool color story. I would never have thought that this was going to be the Tinkerbell palette. I don't know what I was thinking it was going to be looking like, but not this. This has a little bit of grunge, and I just really do love the color story of the palettes, and I do really love the colors. I did a look, I was so pleased with the look, and this is, I think, the best palette that I've tried from ColourPop this year, and one of the best palettes I have from ColourPop, and I would never thought I was going to feel that about a Tinkerbell palette. And this is just so strange for me, like with a Powerpuff palette, it is such a boring palette, but the Tinkerbell is such a fun palette, and it really has some dark shades, it has a really nice shimmers, and it is just such a good palette, and it is a collab with Tinkerbell. I would never thought that the collab palette I would like the most from ColourPop would be ColourPop and Tinkerbell. So that for me was really like surprising. And when I used this palette, I was like, this is really good. I do really like this. I like how dark I can get it with a Tinkerbell palette. So that was the biggest curveball for me this year. Never ever have I thought that Tinkerbitch and me was going to agreeing on something, but apparently we do. Next question, question number 5 is, what was the biggest letdown snoozefest of this year? And I'm going to talk about ColourPop again, I'm so sorry. But I have to say the Nightmare Before Christmas collab. I love the Nightmare Before Christmas movie. I do not know how many times I've seen it. I saw it a long, long time ago for the first time, and I do really love that movie. And when ColourPop finally said that they were going to do a collab with The Nightmare Before Christmas, I was so excited. And then they released the pictures of the palette. And I was like, what the fuck is this? Have you ever even seen the movie? I know that some people did really like it. For me, it doesn't say Nightmare Before Christmas at all. You could have put whatever name on it and I wouldn't like thought on the Nightmare Before Christmas. I was so disappointed. I was really looking forward to buy a Nightmare Before Christmas palette, and ColourPop, they got my hopes up when they did the Tinkerbell collection and then the Nightmare Before Christmas, and I was like, what is this? This is so, so boring. I thought they missed so many things to put in this palette, and no, it wasn't a good collab at all. And I was looking forward to it so much, and I was like, if somebody could do a really good collab with Nightmare Before Christmas, it should be ColourPop, but apparently not. I was just so disappointed. Maybe a little bit happy because I saved some money, but I thought it was such a boring palette and I didn't buy anything. So no, that was like a snoozefest for me. Question number 6. What is the best holiday release this year? And I wish that I would answer Melt on this. I haven't bought the What is it even called? I haven't bought the holiday collection from Melt. I thought that I was going to because I bought last year and the year before that. I have been really loving those palettes. But the palette this year, I think it's too big and not that fun. Even though I've seen really good reviews on it, and I'm actually thinking of maybe buying it if it ever goes on sale on Beauty Bay. But yeah, I'm a little bit disappointed. It was not the best holiday release. I actually think that it is the Lunar Beauty and Moonspell 2. I haven't bought that either, even though I said that I was going to, but I haven't. I do really like the palette they did. I love the first Moonspell, and I do think that Moonspell 2 is really good as well, and I do love the lipstick they released to it. So I think that is the best holiday release for me, and I have a little cat behind me. It's Astrid. So yeah, I think the Lunar Beauty moves well too, even though I haven't buy it, but I think that is the best release, holiday release. And I actually don't know, it doesn't feel like it has been so many holiday releases. I don't know if it is because of the situation in the world or what it is, but yeah, I don't know. But Moonspell 2, I think they did a great job, and I love that they did the second one of them, and I love the lipstick to it. So question number 7 is, what was the best collabs of 2021? And this was hard because I've tried so many fun collab palettes, but one palette, I'm going to show you two palettes, but one of the palettes is absolutely the Club Nebula from Kaleidos. I think a lot of people that are doing this tag is going to say this palette, because this is just an amazing palette. This is between Kaleidos and Angelica Nyqvist. I did receive this in PR. If I wouldn't, I would have bought it. I do really love this palette. This is one of the palettes that I've used most this year, and I do love everything about this. I love the color story, I love the layout, I love the shadows. I just love it, and this has helped me so much this year to really sit down and do a makeup look. I've used it in First Impression, Pal Bingo, Two Looks One Palette, think maybe two Get Ready With Me's, and I just really do love this palette. I'm so happy that I have it. I'm so happy for Angelica to do a collab palette with Kaleidos, and I just think they did a wonderful palette, and this is one of the best collab palettes ever. The second collab palette that I want to talk about is from Minaudry and Anna's Makeup Corner, the Serenity palette, that looks like this. I have done 3 videos, First Impression, Palette Bingo, and 3 Looks One Palette, and I do really, really like this palette. This has a little bit of the same as Club Nebula has. It's really easy to do looks with. You can do a really nice green eye look if you want to, a blue eye look, a purple eye look. And I think the shimmers is really good in this, and the mattes are really, really good, especially like these two light ones. On me, that is really pale. They work amazing, and also this one is a really nice light shimmer shade. So yeah, this is also one of my absolute favorite color palettes, and yes, Annette is my friend. I would have loved it either way, and I love shimmer orange. So yeah, this one and Club Nebula is my favorite collab palettes of this year. I have used other collab palettes, but these two are my absolute favorite collab palettes of this year. And the last question that I think is maybe the hardest question of them all is, what are your predictions for releasing during next year? And I'm not good at this. But I think there will be more collab palettes with smaller indie brands and smaller influencers. That has been a lot this year. And I also think that cream products and multi-use products is going to be bigger. For example, I have, still in the package, I have the two reasons from Nabla that it's a multi-use cream product. I think this is going to be bigger next year. And I also think like a more neutral base is going to be bigger next year. I think it has started to be like more skin tints this year than it has been before, and I'm all for that. I do love skin tints. So I think that is going to be bigger, and I also think that multichromes, it's going to be bigger. I think before, like 1 year ago, or even in the beginning of this year, it was mainly smaller indie brands that did really many multichromes, and it feels like some bigger indie brands is going to hop on that bandwagon and doing multichromes. I know it's expensive to do multichromes, but I feel like it's going to be more, and maybe it's going to like hit the stores with multichromes even here in Sweden. Maybe LH Cosmetics had done some multichromes in the past, but it has not been like a big thing. But I think it's going to be bigger next year. And yeah, maybe that is what I think is going to happen next year. More neutral makeup, multichromes, more multi-use products, and a little bit more cream products. And with that said, I am not that up to date with the makeup releases because I'm trying to go on a no-buy. But that is what I feel is going to happen next year. And you know what? I actually think that it was all for this tag video. I don't even know what I've talked about. I don't know. But I do really hope you liked this video. And don't forget to check out Madeleine. And also don't forget to check out Madeleine. She is so sweet. And I really hope that more will find her channel. And I hope that all of you that's watching this is going to hop over to Madeleine. She is amazing, and I think she's going to do so many fun videos next year. And one thing I must say about her, like the first video I watched from her, I was so proud of her, and she feels so like confident in front of the camera. If I look back to my first videos, I don't know how that was, but she feels really like comfortable in front of the camera. And I am a little bit jealous, but also proud about that. So yeah, don't forget to check out Madeleine. She will be in the description. And yeah, I do really hope you like this video. And if you're not subscribed to my channel, I hope that you won't do that. And now I lost track of what I was going to say. If you're not subscribed to my channel, please do so you don't miss any of my videos. That is what I usually say. So yeah. I really hope you like this video, and also Merry Christmas, because it's soon Christmas in Sweden. We celebrate on Friday. So yeah, I really hope you like this video, and I hope that I will see you in the next one. Bye!